Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. Now, this Try It Tuesday is about skincare. A lot of you guys were very interested in my skincare, which I will have an upcoming video very soon about my updated skincare routine. But basically, a lot of you were very interested in the essences that I've been using on my skin for the past couple of years. There are three in particular, and this is a comparison of all three instead of a single product review. The first thing that I'm going to be talking about is the SK-II Facial Treatment Essence, and then I'm going to be talking about the Estee Lauder Micro Essence, which is also a very similar type of thing. And then finally, the Hera Cell Essence, which is what I'm using at the moment. I don't have any negative feelings towards any of these products, just as an upfront sort of disclaimer. So basically, to start off, an essence is something that you use on your skin before you start anything of your skincare routine. It goes before your lotion or your toner, and basically it works to improve your skin's qualities, the quality of your skin basically. It's not really made for moisturizing in particular. It's really made to combat things like aging, wrinkles, and give you smoother, clearer, brighter skin and those kinds of things. So that's what an essence is. Some people actually like to use it as a toner, but it generally goes right at the beginning of your entire skincare routine. And although it doesn't have any really immediate effects, such as like a glossy skin finish or some kind of really moisturized skin finish, it does work in the long term, and I definitely recommend that you invest in an essence if you're starting to really take care of your skin, or if you're starting to feel like you're having bad skin days. Really, the earlier you start, the better. I started using the SK-II Facial Treatment Essence about 5 years ago when I started using my Hera products as well. And before that, I had not really used any proper skincare routine. I mean, I just had a simple like lotion and moisturizer, but that's pretty much all. And that was really not enough for my skin at that time, but I didn't really care about my skin back then. But once I started incorporating this into my skincare routine, my skin became really visibly smoother, clearer. It was really even toned and like glowing. It looked so healthy. And if you guys go back to my like very first videos on YouTube, you might be able to see that skin that I had from using this and my Hera skincare routine. So the SK-II Facial Treatment Essence, without blabbing too much, is a very liquidy kind of essence. It's really light water, and the key ingredient is pitera, and it's a fermented rice water. A lot of people swear by this product and say it's like their miracle product. Of course, there are people who've been paid to say this, such as Kate Blanchett, and there are people who actually mean it. And then on the other hand, there are people who really break out from it as well, probably because of something to do with it not really matching with your skin. This is definitely a hit or miss kind of product. So I definitely recommend you guys to go and check out a sample of it before you invest in it, because it is very expensive. It is more than $1 per mil. So for 150 mils, it's $165. Being one of the most expensive essences out there on the market. But out of all three that I'm reviewing today, this is the most expensive. It comes in a variety of different sizes. There's like 75 mils, 125, and then it goes all the way up to 330. I used this for about 3 or 4 years, up until I'd say beginning of this year. And the reason that I moved on was simply just because I thought it was very expensive and my skin wasn't really like changing or anything. So I thought I might as well just go out and try some other essence. But to be really honest with you guys, and I don't want to cause any controversy or conspiracy theories here, but it really is because I'm a little bit concerned about radiation. Although there are some companies that say that they do the testing really well and things like that, it's just my personal decision that I have just chosen to steer away a little bit. Don't take it offensively, or please don't take it as a statement of all statements. Basically, the SK-II, if there's anything that I would like to say, this definitely improved my skin for the few years that I used it. It definitely made my skin very smooth, very glowy. It did help kind of make my pores smaller. So I do have good and positive reviews about the SK-II. It's just that every person will find it working differently on their own skin. So definitely, definitely grab a sample of it. And of course, it's very expensive. And thirdly, the smell is a little bit funky. So if you've never smelt it before, just prepare for a sort of like rottenish fermented smell. It's very subtle, but it does have that kind of dried saliva, yucky kind of scent. It's not yucky, but it is not pleasant. I guess it's a good thing that they haven't put fragrance and things like that in it. So I would say out of all three, SK-II has the best packaging because the other two are big glass bottles and SK-II's ones are all sort of plasticky, so they're actually really good for travel. Of course, this is the travel size, so discount that. But I'm gonna move on to Micro Essence by Estee Lauder, which I started using this year. I've been using it for about 6 months together with Oppa, and that's how much I have left. And as you can see, it's a beautiful stained frosted glass, kind of triangular shape at the top, but then it becomes round at the bottom. And it's got a gold cap. It's a twist open kind of cap. The SK-II is also twist open, but you can buy the pump separately for, I think, the larger quantity ones. And this is the Skin Activating Treatment Lotion. They are actually very different in terms of the essences themselves. The SK-II is more getting smoother, more even toned skin, and it does claim that it helps to fight wrinkling and aging. Whereas the Estee Lauder Micro Essence is more of a toner, I feel like it is. It's a lot more stickier, and although it's the same kind of wateriness, it has a little bit more of a sort of serum-like finish to it. So I would actually recommend this one more for those who have dry skin and want to have an essence that helps to do those things, I guess, whilst it focuses on the moisturizing aspect of it. Pricing wise, it's $95. This is very watery and it does leave a slightly sticky feeling to the skin, but it really moisturizes well. I haven't found that it helps to really do that much. My skin didn't really drastically improve or anything. It was just a good essence. So that's why I guess I've kind of moved on to try some other stuff. All of the essences kind of claim the same kind of thing. But as I am explaining to you guys, from my experience, I think each essence has a particular strength that really stands out. The Heracel essence is also quite similar to the Micro Essence in terms of packaging. It's a frosted white glass container, but it's a little bit more frosted, so you can't see through it as much. It's got a beautiful purple top and it's got a sort of like silvery purple glistening theme to it. It's the Cell Biofluid Sync, and this is 150 mils, and this is much cheaper than the other two. It's $60 and it claims to balance, moisturize, revitalize, energize, and even your skin, add brightness, add transparency, and firm and moisturize. So it's a lot of different claims, and it has the five main ingredients listed at the front. There's actually some markings on the side of the bottle, which is very interesting. I noticed that Iope's one also has it, the Iope Bio Conditioning Essence, which a lot of you guys have been asking about. That is exactly the same price as this, and I went and checked it today. The container is really, really similar. It's just a different color and it says Iope on it. It's the same price, but I tried it today and I think it is very similar to the Hera in terms of texture. So both the Iope and Hera have these markings. It says 5 mils a day. And actually, when you purchase this Hera one, it comes in this large box here. And it comes with this box of facial care cotton, and it's 100% natural. And the cotton is actually really good quality. You're basically supposed to put your fingers through it like this, soak the cotton in this area here, and then wipe it across your face, starting from the center of the nose and away towards your cheeks, down across your nose, up and around this area around your wrinkle area here, and your cheeks, and of course your forehead. Always starting from the center, moving outwards. This applies with all of the three essences, so I'm sort of just teaching you guys. But I think it's really great that it comes with this. It really makes it handy to use, and you don't have to buy things separately. Freebies are always good. Now, in terms of the actual product itself, it is a clear liquid. It's a little bit misty. I say the Estee Lauder is the most almost thick kind of watery texture. The Hera is really just like water, and the SK-II is almost even lighter than water. The SK-II sort of just disappears into the skin. Estee Lauder's settles onto the skin and then it leaves a little bit of a sticky surface, so it feels really nice and moisturized, I guess. It feels plump. There's no really refreshing feeling unless you've refrigerated the product beforehand. And the Hera one is moisturizing, but after about 20 seconds, it kind of just sinks right into your skin and then just leaves your skin feeling supple. There's no sticky feeling. The smell of the Hera essence is really pleasant and it's very subtle. So I think it definitely does have fragrance in it. So if you're looking for a nice fragrance smell in your products, then this is the way to go. But if you have sensitive skin, obviously I would recommend the Micro Essence by Estee Lauder. The Hera one I have found really works well with brightening your skin tone and making your skin a little bit more whiter and clearer. That's what I have found, and it really smooths the skin as well. So yeah, that was the rundown of all of the strengths and comparison of all three. Obviously I'm holding it in order of expensiveness, and in terms of the smell, SK-II is the worst. Estee Lauder's one actually has a tiny, very subtle fermented smell as well, but it's not as strong as the SK-II. Hera's one works better for whitening. SK-II works best for smoothing the skin and diminishing the size of your pores, I think. And the Estee Lauder Micro Essence works best for moisturizing and hydrating. So it really depends on what you are looking for. And if you're wondering about the Iope Bio Essence conditioning essence, I would probably say it's very similar to the Hera one, so it's really up to you, whichever you want to try. I'm not really sure if the Iope comes with a free box of cotton, but you know, essences are very subjective. You have to just try out a sample and see if it works for you. As long as it doesn't break you out, you will be able to see some differences in your skin if you've never used an essence before. And make sure to incorporate it together with a lotion, a serum, and moisturizer, and eye cream, of course. So yeah, that's pretty much it for this video. If you have any questions, just leave it down below, and I will put a link in the info bar for those of you who are looking for an online website that's reliable that you can purchase these products from. So hopefully this was a very useful video for you guys. I compared all three products. For next week's Tripe Tuesday, I may or may not do it. Just keep a watch out for my Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook. If I get to try out my Etude House BB cushions by then I possibly will do it. But just check out my recent Korean haul beauty video and see if there's anything in there that you would like me to actually do a review of. Leave it down in the comments below or on my Instagram, Facebook, Twitter when I put up my Try It Tuesday vote next week. So yeah, that's it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Thumbs it up if you liked it, and I will talk to you guys in my next video. Bye guys. 5x5 is just the most gorgeous blue color, and if you do like one coat, it's got a really nice transparent kind of blue color. It's really pretty, and you can build it up to like two or three shades to make it really opaque.